So I was talking about it on the Discord, thinking about things that we could do to prepare the community for the development avalanche that inevitably awaits for XYO Network. Those of you who don't know, I know, I'm Arch Anglo, and I'm going to be talking about XYO. And we're going to get started on some tips and tricks trying to get your local environment set up for your Archivist. So, without any further ado, alright, so let's get into it. The first thing you're going to want to do is go ahead and get started with VirtualBox. Once you got that downloaded, I'm going to choose for Windows. Go through the standard installation features. So while that's happening, try to notepad. Okay, so now that that's sorted, you'll go ahead and start a new virtual machine on your Windows host. First thing you're going to want to do is hit this add. And then go ahead and enter whatever name suits you. And then it's going to automatically choose the drive in which you are going to install the VirtualBox server. Today we're going to be using Linux, and scroll down here to Ubuntu 64-bit. Now you can allocate the amount of RAM that you want for your machine. I have quite a bit available, so this red line here is where you max out. So I'll go ahead and just push it to the edge here. And that's the maximum amount of RAM that you can allocate before your machine starts seeing interruptions, your host machine. So go ahead and set that up. Create the virtual hard disk. Create the VirtualBox disk image. Now, here it's asking you how you want to allocate your disk space. We'll have further tutorials for that on the GeoHacker forum on how to configure different partitions for your archivist. So being that the archivist and Diviner is essentially a database server, it requires a lot of disk space. And so in order to do that efficiently, there's a lot of different methods that are covered in the Discord, so I'm not going to get into that. But for your virtual box, you're just going to want to go ahead and do dynamically allocated, and this will use the resources that are on the machine until there's not enough to be allocated to the server. So that's pretty simple and straightforward. We got that set up. So now we're going to move on to settings. And I like to encrypt the disk. So automatically it's telling me I have invalid settings. So I imagine the problem here is that I haven't installed the extensions pack, so we're going to go ahead and do that. Excuse me. There it is. Agree to the terms. So let's resume configuring the settings for our new virtual host. So now you'll see it allows for there we go. So this is going to encrypt the hard drive, or the virtual hard drive, with SHA-256. Enter your password, and then I like to move on to advanced settings. And then using this settings, now you can go ahead and copy and paste things onto your virtual machine using your mouse. I don't know who uses floppy disks, but that's there if you fancy it. Processor, now I've got a couple of CPUs to spare, so I'll just go ahead and do that, otherwise I might cut out the video. Let's move on to display, and since I intend on installing a GUI, or a graphic user interface, for my server, I'll set the video memory up and enable the 3D. And then we move on to storage. And this is where you should have previously installed Ubuntu server. And in order to do that, we'll go to the official website and hit this download link right here. And once you do that, it'll be in your download folder. And once you get to the storage settings in your VirtualBox, you'll click on the disk, come to this drop down, and you'll go ahead and choose the file. It's already recognized that I have this ISO here, so I'm going to go ahead and just click on it. That's the one we want. Server. And then we're going to move over to networking. So the way I prefer to run the Archivist is on a bridge adapter. So this is just going to let you go ahead and use the Ethernet adapter that is on your machine in order to power your and so if you have a Wi-Fi card, this will show up here. I have an Ethernet adapter, so I'm just going to move on. Once the savings are set, you're going to go ahead and start your Ubuntu server. Extra window open here. So this is the password that you set earlier to encrypt the disk. Now it's starting up the server for the first time. So now we have some stuff to do. All right, and that's where I'll leave you for the next video.